So to the first gold medal match of the 2012 Olympics at the badminton competition. It's mixed doubles, it's an all Chinese affair. The number one seeds and the current world champions, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, up against the number two seeds, Zhu Chen and Ma Jin.
Ladies and gentlemen, and as you can see,
five matches for each of them, five wins, because in the mixed doubles we started with 16 pairs divided into four groups of four. Everybody had to play everybody else within the group, and then the top two from the group progressed to the knockout stage straight into the quarterfinal. So only two previous matches played by each of these pairs in the knockout to get through to this gold medal match. Being introduced to the crowd here at Wembley. Wembley really has looked magnificent during the games.
The next match on board is the mixed doubles gold medal match. Please welcome, representing the People's Republic of China, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei.
The number one seeds, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei of China, and they'll have very happy memories of this Wembley Arena. This is where they won their world title last year. Our opponents, the number two seeds, also from China. There they are, Zhu Chen and Ma Jin. Of course, were the All England champions last year. All England champions have really been unseeded.
Red or black?
United States of America. Great honour for the court officials to be appointed to officiate an Olympic final. Zhang Nan, 22-year-old, born in Beijing. His partner, Zhao Yunlei, 25 years of age, so she'll be turning 26 at the end of this month. The seeds had a terrific match in the semi-final against the number four seeds from Denmark, Joachim Fischer Nielsen and Christina Pedersen. Zhang Nan from Hubei province. Zhang Nan, interesting that openly talked about his ambitions, wasn't named as winning an Olympic gold medal, it was to gain the trust of his coach, Li Yongbo. Here's how they've got to today's final. Danes in the knockout stage, all of their group matches in two straight games, defeated the former world champions Thomas Laybourne and Camilla Ruta-Yul in the quarterfinal. And as I'm saying, their semi-final, an absolute thriller against Fischer Nielsen and Pedersen. and then dropped the opening eight, and he came back in an hour and 22 minutes. Well, there's Margin, the 24-year-old from Qingdao. And of course, Qingdao was the venue for the Olympic sailing event for the 2008 Olympics. Zhu Chen, 27th from Jiangsu province. And he's a bit of a keen follower of football, as Zhu Chen. He's a powerful athlete too. Had a smash at 295 kilometres an hour during the final of the Korean Open earlier this year. Well, you look at their quarterfinal there against the Polish pair, the European champions, Robert Matusiak and Nadia Ziba, because they had to save a match point in the deciding game. Saved a match point at 20-21, but eventually won 23-21 in an hour and 5 minutes. And then in their semi-final against the number three seeds, Tantowi Ahmad and Luana Natsia of Indonesia, once again dropped the opening game before coming back 21-13 in an hour and 15 minutes in the decider. So this pair, Zhu Chen and Ma Jin, physically have had to work harder to battle their way through to this final. This is the 11th meeting between these two players in the previous 10. It is the world champions, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, who won 8 of them. There he is, the world champion. Practice serve into the net. I wonder if he's a little bit nervous. That would be understandable. I suspect this will become a battle between the two women, the control of the front. First badminton Olympic gold medal to be decided. Yes, the number one seeds, and especially Zhang Nan, is very nervous indeed. Wild error on that opening point. Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei in the all yellow kits, number two seeds, Zhu Chen and Ma Jin in the red. And there's the little hand signal that we'll see all the time from Ma Jin. Just letting her partner know where she's going to serve to. Clearly been the two outstanding mixed doubles pairs over the last year or so. And Peter, I was saying a little earlier that I thought that this would be a battle between the two women. That would really decide this final, who could take control of the net, whether it's Zhao Yunlei, there she is, or whether it's her opponent, Ma Jin. Now, many people will find that quite surprising, because, of course, men are physically stronger than women, and most people would assume that it's the man who's going to decide this with his power play. It's not always the case.
No, it certainly is not, Jill. It's about how the woman can direct the play from the front court, how she sets up for her partner, the blocks, how she reads the play at the front court as well. So important in mixed doubles. It's not all about power, it's about the finesse around the front court set up for your partner.
That said, of course, both these particular female players are incredibly strong at the back of the court, and therefore their partners won't panic if they get pushed to the back. But the ideal formation for mixed doubles is, of course, using the man's power from the back of the court, and the women tend to be a little more agile and therefore a little quicker and able to read the play at the front of the court. So you'll see them trying to play to that strength, that formation, as indeed the world champions did in that rally.
Yeah, it's certainly true, Jill, and you know, the man, he can commit to the front court if he has got that confidence of the female at the back of the court, but it's not the ideal situation. But at times it can be an advantage if they've got the confidence to totally commit off the serve, because the first three strokes are so important.
Oh my goodness. Well, the defence there from Zhao Yunlei, absolutely extraordinary. Of course, a former world champion in mixed doubles, won the gold medal in Paris in 2010, but playing with Zheng Bo on that occasion. Since then, Zheng Bo has been dismissed from the National Training Center. Head coach thought he had a bad attitude and therefore replaced him with Zhu Chen in this mixed doubles partnership. Well, just to confirm that the score is actually 5-3. What a rally. How did they get themselves out of trouble? Found the gap. I think both players are going to be very reluctant actually to lift the shuttle. They're both very aware of the attacking capabilities of their opponent.
Well, they would certainly know each other's game, that's for sure. They've played each other on many occasions in Chen regularly.
Yeah, all four players based at the National Training Center in Beijing.
Great interception at the front court. That's what we're talking about, that dominance at the front of the court.
Isolating Zhao Yunlei with their attacking play. Example of a rally with neither pair prepared to lift it. The little pushes, the drives. That's a very, very good return of serve from Margin.
Isn't it? The pressure at the front court, setting up for the kill. Lovely finish there by Zhao Yunlei.
Too flat and it was going to go long of the back line. And this has been a very dominant start to this Olympic final. Only number one seeds, Jeremy and Jeremy, and they 6 point advantage at the mid-game interval. And of course, because there's two Chinese pairs contesting this final, Chinese coaching staff don't show any favouritism. Well, Chinese fans will be happy, won't they?
Yes, they certainly will. It's definitely end up with a gold and silver out of this match. Yao Yunlei, she really has control from the front court and stood up to that attack too, and it's so important in the mixed doubles to be able to put a woman to stand up that attack and flatten out.
Yeah, and I do think that Zhao Yunlei tends to be a little more aggressive with her interceptions at the front of the court. Margin intercepts an awful lot, but a lot of the time she just blocks the shuttle.
Blocking around the front court that you're talking about, Jill, that's really effective if you are anticipating the shuttle and taking it early. If you've got a lot of speed around the front court and can match it with your opponent, then the blocks are so effective in mixed doubles. Otherwise, you need to press and get your opponent to the back court.
There, having Zhu Chen at the front of the court, Margin at the back.
Well, definitely can work on some occasions. If you're going to hit it short to Zhu Chen at the front court, it's going to be put away pretty quickly. It really is about maintaining that front court pressure, especially in the first three strokes. Well, they weren't going to let up on the pressure there. Good switch. Putting the attack onto Yao Yunlei to finish the shuttle. That's the speed that I was talking about. She can take the shuttle nice and high to the net. She doesn't have to put any power onto it. It's a really sharp return of serve.
Chen and Mary Jin thought it was long.
It's a nice shot right on the line on the outside edge. I'm calling that one good, Jill.
It was so close, wasn't it?
A good placement too, down between the players, just splitting them.
Trying to go for the lines too much, I think. Chen.
He certainly does generate a lot of power off the overhead, as you can see here. Gee, he brought it down with a lot of angle.
Been overruled by the umpire, and I have to say, I think she was right.
Yes, it looks like it was just wide of the line.
Yeah, good overrule by the umpire.
That interception attack.
Yeah, the third shot that you were talking about. Anticipating the return from Zhu Shen. She was in the right place at the right time. No question in my mind, Zhao Yunlei is winning the battle at the front of the court at the moment.
Well, she certainly is anticipating well at the front court. Dominating a lot of the play, and as you're saying, Jill, she hits it with that little bit more pace, a little bit more power, which really puts the pressure on her opponents.
Well, I thought right at the start of this final that it was Zhang Nan that was looking a little bit nervous. He seems to have settled, and it's Zhu Chen who's spraying the shuttle out wide, making one or two errors. Oh dear, way out of position. Well, it was the cross-court block that did the damage. Delightful shot. Chu Chen did well to get it back, actually. But he played his partner into trouble by lifting cross-court. 9 game points. Brilliant. Wonderful rally to finish off the opening game. 21-11. And at the moment, the world champions are totally dominant.
And so they're really combining well. Front of the court, now Yunlei, she's dominating the play. Zhang Nan, very
champions 21-11. And 18 minutes of play. Now, what can the number 2 seeds do to respond? Of course, the reigning world champions won the All England Championships back in 2010 as qualifiers. First pair ever to do that, and they weren't high enough on the world ranking because they were a brand new partnership. And to qualify and win the tournament. But they're in full flow at the moment.
They've really started off the second game just where they left the first. A combination. Power play at the front of the court.
And of course, we've already talked about the fact that they'll know each other's games very well indeed, because they train together, spar against each other in the National Training Center. But not only that, Zhang Nan actually used to play with Margin. Played in the East Asian Games in Hong Kong in 2009 and actually won a silver medal together.
Well, no, their game inside out, wouldn't they, really?
Yep.
But Xu Chen, he just seems to be still very, very tight. He's making the errors off the return of serve. He's just overplaying his shots.
He's getting more frustrated with himself. He's not showing it externally, but I just think, as with that last shot, missed the drive. It's almost as if you can see an internal panic button being pushed.
Yeah, I think it's certainly the case. And he really needs to talk to his partner and look at how they can get back into this game, how he can set up for her and work the front court.
Oh, magnificent.
Defense like that, he's in a lot of trouble, isn't he? That's wonderful cross-court lift.
I was surprised that Margin on the return of serve just lifted the shuttle to the back of the court. I would have thought that in any doubles discipline, you've got to try and get on the attack. You can't really expect to win nowadays by defending. Maybe she's just so afraid of the speed of this lady at the front of the court. She thought it was preferable to lift a Zhang Nan at the back. It's brilliantly constructed again, isn't it?
Well, if that's the case, Jill, then it's not really a positive approach, is it? It's not going out there and backing yourself and saying, right, I'm going to take this game right up to the opposition. And this is the difference you can see here. Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, they're taking it right up to them, putting the pressure right on the opponents.
Rally after rally.
And they're combining so well. And you know, the traditional format with Yao Yunlei at the net. And just smashing over her shoulder as well, so just allowing for the shuttle to come back and for her to be able to direct the play and read it off the racket from the front court.
Get a point on the board, and that's appreciated by the fans here at Wembley. She took a long, long time on her serve there, Margin. That's the one you were talking about, Pete, where she just takes the pace off, where she takes it early.
Yeah, she read the play well there, and she backed herself as well. Took the shuttle high, placed it nicely. It's really about whether Margin can get into the rallies, whether she can start to control from the front court. If they're going to come back in this second game, that's paramount. It's a wonderful attacking combination, isn't it? They really play well for one another.
Yes, they have this real understanding, don't they?
And you can see that, and I think that's a big difference between the two pairs.
Yeah, that is brilliant. Absolutely magnificent from Zhao Yunlei.
They're not releasing the pressure at all here, are they? Just continually a barrage of attack.
She was going to play that. Well, he hasn't had many opportunities to unleash his big smash. Well, that was certainly one of them. Now the umpire there. Was just saying you've got to hand back the shuttle or don't interfere with the shuttle.
I thought she was talking about the change of the shuttle and asking before she did change the shuttle.
Well, I think if all four players on court agree that the shuttle should be changed, that really ought to be that.
I agree.
Oh my goodness gracious. Oh, I don't believe it. Well, there was a couple of retrievals there from Yu Chen and Mao Jin. And in all honesty, it seemed a little impossible, but somehow they managed to get it back and got it back with interest. But in the end, to no avail. Look at that. He was on his knees. And then that defensive shot from Mao Jin. Absolutely extraordinary. Fans very much enjoying the occasion here. It's a pity it ended on an error because it was an excellent rally.
Yes, and much better play from Zhu Zhen and Ma Jin as well. Just getting the opportunity to maintain that attack. It's so important in the mixed doubles. So far through this whole match, it's been Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei that have been controlling the attack. Thank you.
pushed it wrong. Sometimes I think he's so intent on hitting it hard, he forgets to come over the shuttle sometimes.
For Yao Yunlei, attacking down her racket side. Much better placement than the shot before. But it's about keeping a cool head and a clear mind, especially in such a big occasion like this. Being able to think about that variation in attack with the cut as well as the full power smash.
Yeah, she always wears that knee support on her right knee, so don't be too alarmed. It's not a new injury.
Jen and Marjen, they just seem to be now putting that flat attack in a lot more during the game. They're not looking to lift, but they're finding it very difficult against such a class opposition that they're looking to do the same. They're not going to be able to give the shuttle up and lift it high.
Under severe pressure there, Zhu Chen, and defensively managed to keep the shuttle so tight over the net. That was the one. Just sense that the number two seeds have to make a little run of points here. Time running out there. Yeah, they might. And the opponents will know it too.
They've been much more effective in this second game of constructing their rallies and placing it to the side, keeping it flat, not giving up the attack too easy. It's a big smash, isn't it? Wonderful play.
Straight points, and the 8-point deficit has been halved. all of a sudden there's belief.
The thing is, they are now starting to take charge of the rallies too. They're really moving forward at the front court, looking to keep it flat. And as I said before, they're not willing to give up the attack easy, which is much better play.
Oh my goodness, she slipped over. Very good judgment in the end, but I was very concerned. She seemed to lose her footing earlier on in that. Oh my goodness, that was plumb on the line. That's called out. No overall this time from the umpire.
That's a nice play. Well, they certainly sharpened up their return of serve. Pressing to the corner there, well played.
Well, Zhang Nan turns to his partner, says, come on. Away from the Olympic gold medal. Oh, it's landed well in. That really was a must-win rally as far as Zhu Chen and Ma Jin were concerned. Believe it. Extraordinary rally. Wonderful rally. Full stretch. Zhang Nan. And then somehow Ma Jin managed to not only get it back, but get it back with interest. This has become very interesting indeed. The deficit is narrowed to just 2 points. Remember, they were 8 points adrift at one stage. 8-16 down they were. Now 17-19. This is a big point. Oh, the clash of rackets between Zhu Chen and Ma Jin. Both going for the same shot, and that landing just wide. of the sideline. And that means that the world champions Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei have 3 gold medal points. That's it. They've done it. They've added the Olympic title to their world title. Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei. And apart from a few nerves right at the end of that second game, they were absolutely superb today. Zhao Yunlei controlled the front of the court. Two straight games. And Zhang Nan rushes off to the crowd to grab the Chinese flag. 21-11. 21-17, and Li Yongbo can look down on centre court here, a happy man, because China have once again won the Olympic gold medal in mixed doubles. Of course, 4 years ago, a big surprise when Li Yongdei and Li Huojong took the final against the Indonesian pair. Gold medal winners, Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei of China. They are the 5th Olympic mixed doubles champions. Of course, in case you think I'm getting that wrong, this is badminton's 6th Olympics. Being the first ever badminton Olympics in Barcelona in 1992, there was no mixed doubles discipline.
Ladies and gentlemen, the medal ceremony for the mixed doubles will commence shortly. Please stay your seats.
Twice Korea have won the gold medal in the mixed doubles, and now for a third time, China take gold. Oh, Peter, as we look at those wonderful celebrations from Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, they were, in all honesty, the better pair today.
Oh, they certainly were. They played a wonderful game, and they really did work for one another. Zhao Yunlei at the front of the court, dominating on the majority of the occasions, and Zhang Nan really supporting her well at the back. It was that little this bit in the middle, but they finished it out well.
Yes, they certainly did. 21-11, 21-17 in 43 minutes. All these two Chinese pairs in the mixed doubles came here as the top 2 seeds. Have won the gold medal in the mixed doubles, and now for a third time, China take gold. Oh, Peter, as we look at those wonderful celebrations from Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, they were, in all honesty, the better pair today.
Oh, they certainly were. They played a wonderful game, and they really did work for one another. Zhao Yunlei at the front of the court, dominating on the majority of the occasions, and Zhang Nan really supporting her well at the back. It was that little this bit in the middle, but they finished it out well.
Yes, they certainly did. 21-11, 21-17 in 43 minutes. Two Chinese pairs in the mixed doubles came here as the top two seeds. They really have shown their class throughout this Olympic competition.